Hello, this is Graham. Hope everyone's having a great day. If you're like me, I take a lot of images with the compact digital cameras such as this TZ20 from Panasonic. On my daily hikes and walks, I don't normally carry my Canon EOS range of cameras with a big shoulder bag. I prefer just to take this little small camera with me. Optically, it gives me almost as good an image as the Canon EOS. Plus, it gives me the combined features of a wide-angle lens and telephoto lens all in one compact camera. The video quality isn't bad at all, and I prefer to use this now than the EOS 60D. But it does give me a problem. With the LCD screen in bright daylight, I just can't see the image on the screen. More importantly, I can't check the critical focus when I'm using the camera. With using the compact digital camera, I found I was losing too many images due to the camera selecting the wrong focal point, and without reviewing them at the scene, I'd missed that opportunity. So I thought I'd look at how to view this screen in a condition where I could actually see clearly the contents of the screen. I'm normally long-sighted, so I can't see the camera without having at arm's length, and that makes it impossible for me to actually focus on the critical area of the screen. Some of the compact cameras do have live viewfinders, which would be a benefit, like the GF1, GF2. But I've settled for the TZ20 and the LX5 cameras, so I wanted some method of viewing the screen and making sure that I had critical focus. So I went back to a device that I reviewed several months ago, which was the CAPA LCD loop. You may remember from that video review of the CAPA device, I was very critical for the fact that it didn't focus, it didn't give you any diopter adjustment to correct for eyesight. Even though the advertising blur says it's good for -1 to +3, I found it would not focus on the screen. So you may remember in that video, I actually took a hammer and broke the glass out of this and fitted my own precision optics in the back end of it. So I thought this might be of use to attach to the TZ20 or the LX5, both which have a 3-inch LCD screen. Normally this device comes with a self-adhesive magnetic plate which you attach to the LCD screen, and that's what I attached onto the 550D and 60D EOS cameras. But I didn't want to go to the trouble of purchasing another magnetic plate and sticking it onto the back of this touchscreen on the TZ20. So I tried just hand-holding this device against the LCD screen, and it works quite well. The device has got a soft lining to it, so it won't scratch the screen. And just by holding the device onto the back of the screen, it now gives me a clear view of the screen when I hold this viewer to my eye. It also gives me that extra stability when I'm shooting video. So when I look through the loop at the screen, I can actually see in critical definition what I'm actually focusing on, and that way I'm losing less shots. It also gives me the advantage that it gives me that third point of stability for video, so that when it's up against my eye, I now have much more of a stable platform for when I'm shooting video, and I can actually see what the camera's focused on, and when I zoom in, I can actually control the zoom much better. So I think it's a probably worthwhile attachment for compact digital cameras if you're shooting video or, like me, have difficulty seeing the LCD screen in bright sunlight. There is a new version out from CAPA, and they've dropped the price, and I think it's only about £25 now, as against to originally these were £40-odd from eBay retailers. So it's probably worth now looking at the second version of this device from CAPA and using it with your compact travel cameras. Hopefully that's been of interest to someone. If it has, of course, please rate, comment and subscribe. And as usual, this is Graham saying thanks for watching. Bye for now.